News, Queensland.
Good evening. Trapped in the second story of their burning unit, a Gold Coast couple faced the most important and terrifying decision of their lives, to jump or not. With nothing, not even the clothes on their backs to protect them, they took the ultimate leap of faith.
Man versus fire.
Damn, there's people escaping. Holy
adrenaline taking over, neighbours making the desperate dash back into the inferno, consuming their home.
Oh my God, I hope there's no people inside.
You can thank a couple of the nearby homeowners. They actually dragged a couple of people out.
Flames soaring six stories high, smoke billowing into the night sky, embers sparkling like stars as carnage unfolds below.
There's a roof collapsed. No, yeah, the building just collapsed. You can feel it.
Windows shattering, gas bottles exploding, alarms ringing out as the walls crumble around those inside.
The door was on fire, all the glass in the house was just embedded with red flames everywhere.
With no other escape, Jacqueline and Chad leapt for their lives from the second floor.
I pretty had to throw her out. She wasn't going to jump, so I just got it and just presently just, you got to go, darling. Out, and then I jumped. It was either that or crispy chicken, crispy human.
Caught unaware and underdressed.
I had to leave all the clothes behind and basically jump my ass out that window butt naked, yeah.
Now clothed by their generous neighbours, they're just one of dozens of families left with nothing.
Woke up really scared and my partner saw the fire and just told me to rush and get babies. Just couldn't believe it, just fire everywhere, just seemed unreal.
Smouldering for hours, the blaze was so big, backup from New South Wales joined the fight.
We had a lot of men on the ground and we managed to contain it by just surrounding it.
Riddled with asbestos, firefighters today in hazmat, scouring the rubble, the cause likely to be electrical, the damage irreparable.
They've lost everything. Everything's now gone. If it isn't fire affected, it's smoke and water damage because of the heat was so intense. The building's just going to be knocked over.
Sophie Upcroft, Nine News.